Hi, I'm Cynthia for Arby's Cafe, and Sherry is with me today.
Hi, Cynthia.
Hi, Sherry. So today we are showing something completely different. This is the first time for us, and we're pretty excited. We've seen a lot of little embroidery, and something maybe that you don't know is Sherry really enjoy working with fabrics.
I do.
And Sherry, I have to say, I really enjoy working with you because you are such an inspiration.
Oh.
You showed me how to do some embroidery with fabrics, and she did really some amazing things.
Oh,
so I'm excited to show that.
I'm always inspired by you as well. I've got one to share.
I know, it's really good that we can work together because it's really good to share ideas together.
It's fun.
It is. So we've seen all those little fabrics embroidery, and we were super excited. So Sherry, I would love to start with yours because it's so beautiful.
Okay.
And can you explain the process also and how you come up with ideas?
Well, in this particular case, you came with some fabric, and Cynthia brought this little pile of fabric and said, do any of these inspire you?
Uh-huh.
And I started flipping through, and they're all just beautiful. We've got an assortment here. But right away, I just was attracted to this orange red with the greens and browns.
Right.
And
your colors.
I love this kind of a bluish with a little bit of an aqua, and just fell in love with it.
Mm-hmm.
And you knew.
I did. That's hard.
So, I just loved it, and the plan was to do little embroidery, and so I thought, well, I'm just going to cut up these little circles and start there and see where it goes. So I chopped up the fabric into a bunch of little circles and kind of laid them out, played with it a little bit, and this is what I ended up with. I laid it out, it turned into a tree, and it wasn't little anymore.
Right.
it was supposed to be a little embroidery, and it turned into a wall hanging. But no, just a little one. I couldn't stop. It was just so much fun.
It's so pretty.
You brought this kind of burlap and some chambray and this ribbon that has this kind of burlap feel. And so I just kind of laid it all out, and a tree just happened.
Just
So I used the little circles. I layered them on top of either the chambray or this ivory fabric.
Mm-hmm.
And then I used this gorgeous Hana thread and did
just
very basic embroidery stitches, a little blanket stitch, little running stitches, and then just started adding beads, and it just sort of happened. I just one flower at a time. You know, I didn't have a plan. But just started embellishing, and you know, if I were to do it again, I'd do it completely different.
But yes.
I was really pleased with the way it turned out. So it was a lot of
beautiful
fun.
And what I love is when you show it to me, it was only on one piece of fabrics, and then you added the blue fabrics behind it, and it really gives another dimension. It's really pretty, and you added some beads to make
a
hanger. This is so beautiful.
So it was a lot of fun. I enjoyed the whole process of that.
Right.
And then, so we're going to make something little.
That was
now
the goal.
That we've experimented a little.
The goal was to make something small.
Right. So we have these fabulous Nun Design bezels. And I ended up making this little pendant here where I just layered the same little circle on the white background, and then embellished it with beads, and then used the nun frame.
That's beautiful, too.
Yeah.
That's beautiful.
And that was a lot of fun. You could have, how many do I have? There's a whole bunch of jewelry here, right? There's about seven
That's
different pieces
true.
That could have been.
That's
so,
true.
Yeah.
Yes. So what inspired us first is those pieces of fabrics. And you can find like that block of fabrics to a fabric store. And you can find them on sale, and they're pretty cheap.
Yeah.
I mean, I think I bought this one for $10,
and
the
gorgeous,
bunch.
Gorgeous.
Yes.
You get such a fun variety, and often
coordinated.
You brought these strips a while back, and I just love the prints and patterns. When we talked a little bit about, well, what are we going to do? We just went crazy just looking at the fabric. and it could be anything. You could just pick up on these little sprigs and embellish. I love these sweet little birds. You could, cut out the bird just himself or in a circle and embellish with stitches and beads. This gorgeous owl. He's large.
Right.
But he'd be, you know, beautiful little hanging or a large, you could do a large focal pendant. And you don't have to completely bead him, but even just a little outline would be really pretty. So
that's really beautiful.
Yeah, so just the fabric itself is so inspiring.
Yes. And then you made, oh my gosh, this is a gorgeous, gorgeous little pendant. No, a pin.
Well, I fell in love with the hand bead and started there. I stitched it down to some bead backing. And then once it was in place, I thought, okay, what next? What color beads? So I just started picking some colors and just did it one row at a time, surrounded. I knew I wanted to use some bugle beads.
Right.
And so I stitched those on and then one little row and then thought, oh, it needs another row. And then it just kind of grew. And then at some point, I didn't need any more.
Remember,
the idea was small. Right? But I also used this little round section in the middle is a head pin, and it's just gorgeous. And the bead, the hand bead has a hole in the center where you could string a bead if you wanted to, either on stringing material or on a head pin or eye pin. But I love that head pin, and so I attached that to the center and then put the little,
so pretty.
Little chaton in. And yeah, that was a lot of fun to do.
Oh, it is beautiful. Yeah. Beautiful.
Yeah, thank you.
And then more traditional, if I can say, with a rivoli in the middle.
Right, right. Yeah, it has a rivoli. And then again, just one row at a time until you think you have enough.
Right? It's hard to stop.
That's what I love about it. It's just, you don't have to plan too much. You
That's
can
true.
Just start and stop when you think it's done.
Yeah, those are so pretty.
Thank you.
So I was thinking also, what can I make that is really small? And I was on the beach with my daughter, and she showed me, and she was so excited. She said, look, look, Mom, I really like those enamel lapel pins.
Oh, right.
It's very trendy right now, and they have all those cute shape, all those cute animal, fruit, pizza, french fries, you know, all of these. They were so cute.
Oh.
And I thought, I can beat those. I really can make something out of it.
How fun.
So I made a strawberry. This is my strawberry here.
Isn't it sweet?
And then I made the cupcake first. So this is my first try. I'm not super happy with that cupcake. I saw another design, so I'm going to try another design. But it's still pretty cute.
It's darling.
And then here I made a cactus with a little flower. So this one is not finished because I'm still thinking, should I put some embroidery floss, or should I do beads? I'm not sure yet. So I'm
more to go.
The
little flower bead that you have on top for the little bloom is just perfect for
Isn't that.
It's
cute.
It's really sweet.
I think it's really cute. So those are pretty easy to do. Use a bead backing, and then I just draw, like a strawberry, for example. So I don't know how to draw. It's not my it's not my strength. So I went online, look at different design, and I just draw a quick strawberry, for example. And then the way how I did is I start from the outside. So I did, for example, I did the brown on the strawberry. I started with the brown line. So I did the curve of the strawberry, and then I did here the top. And then I just fill up with the beads. That's what I did.
Okay,
you just fill up. I don't really,
yeah.
I didn't really think about a pattern. The same for this one. So you start with the outside and then you just fill up the inside.
Cute.
And it's fast also to do.
Which is nice. You can have several. You can have a whole fruit platter.
Exactly.
Whole assortment.
I was thinking, yes. So my next one that I want to do is, it's a... another cupcake, another cactus,
cute.
And then I'm thinking a coffee cup. We
oh,
are in Washington
cute.
State, Seattle. You need your coffee cup. I mean, there's so many that you can find online. There's so many designs, and they're really, really fun to do. And you, the original, it's yours
right.
because it's your drawing
it
too.
Yes. Cute.
So right now I didn't finish the back, but I'm thinking about gluing a pin like that. And those also, oops, sorry. Those you can find in any craft store also. And I think you did that on that one, right?
Yeah.
You just glue it.
I just glued them.
Right.
I had finished the pins before I had the backs. And after When I saw them, I thought, oh, well, if I hadn't have finished them, maybe I would have poked the pin in from the inside mm-hmm. so that you don't see the whole metal part. But the glue is working out great, so it's perfectly fine the way it is.
Great. Yeah, that's a good idea, maybe to hide the silver. But it looks fine also, like that. Yes. And then I did I did a choker also. So I did this little embroidery and I glue it on the choker.
Cute.
So my advice on that is it's a little heavy. Okay. So you want the choker to really fit around your neck. Yes. Okay. So what I did is the ribbon, I cut it pretty short and then I added a chain in the back like that I can...
I can adjust.
Okay. Yes, but I really advise that it stay pretty close to your neck. Mm-hmm. Mm. Otherwise, it's gonna fall.
Oh, so pretty!
It is, and I use a Swarovski crystal in the middle. It's so pretty.
Oh,
and then because I really like that, I did this other idea, and I just put on a necklace this time. But you can do like little pieces mm-hmm. like that, and just do a little pendant. It is so cute.
It goes pretty fast.
It does. Right? It does. It's a big change from. The embroidery that I do usually, so I'm so excited doing more.
Oh, very fun.
And then you talk about the non-design. You use a non-design bezel,
right.
And we actually have some new non-design kit. And those kits are embroidery kit. And they come with, like for example, this one is a pendant. So it's a bezel, come with a jump ring, and this piece here. And this piece is pretty important because this is the piece that we hold your fabric. And in each kit you have a instruction sheet that show you how to do it, how to cut the fabrics and how to put the fabric around that piece.
Right, how to measure it for the frame.
Yes, mm-hmm. yes, the instructions are very, very nice. And we have also here, part of the kit is a lapel pin. And Sherry, you met such a cute cat here. It's adorable.
Simple
so
little
cute.
Kitty cat. Yeah, that was fun. That really just takes a couple minutes to stitch. And once you're satisfied with your pattern, that might go a little slower, but went really fast and really fun to do. There's like three designs that get you started in the kit, three mm-hmm. little patterns.
Right.
But otherwise, it's whatever embroidery you want to do.
Yes.
And with whatever fabrics mm-hmm. and threads, and then that flat piece, you just then wrap that around, cinch it up, and then glue it into the bezel.
But,
and then you've got a wonderful piece of jewelry. So,
yes.
Really fun kits.
Yes, and I have to say, when I made one, I put the fabric around the piece, and I stitch it. And then I was struggling with it. It's like, what's going on? And I look at the instruction and I'm like, really? I didn't read the instruction first. I should have. Because it explained very well how to stitch it.
Yeah. Oh, cute.
So, you know, I'm the type, I'm not going to look at instruction. But so it's pretty easy to do, actually.
It's very easy and a lot of fun.
Yes, it is. So I made two necklaces. And I don't know how to do embroidery with floss, and I look online, I look at different books, and it was too overwhelming for me, so I did something very simple, but I wanted to try. So I used that fabrics, and I really like the patterns, so I cut around that pattern, and I did some embroidery floss. It's the simple, I think it's called a chain stitch.
Right.
Very simple to do. And then I just glue a flat back on top of it.
I love that.
Oh, thank you.
So that's a perfect example of letting the fabric do the work, basically, right?
Yes.
It kind of set your whole pattern up, and then you just get to make it pretty.
Yes.
That's a lot of fun.
Yes. And it's a big, I mean, I was so happy to, like, wow, I make my first embroidery stitch with floss. So, yay! I want to do more.
Yeah.
So the next that I did is also I use the fabrics, and you have those really pretty flowers. So I cut the flower, and this time I just did beads, a bunch of beads around it. So I follow the outline here of the flowers, and that's all I did, and then fill it up with beads.
So pretty. So pretty. I love
Thank
that.
You.
If you were to look at that finished pendant, you wouldn't know that.
you would see this beautiful beaded flower. And so the fact that you were inspired by the fabric and then had that to use as a pattern is, that's a wonderful thing. It makes it so simple.
Oh, thank you.
And yet you end up with this very unique piece.
Right. Yes. So that's,
so fun.
I think that's the way to start, is choose the fabrics that really inspire you and then just go crazy with beads around it, over embroidery flowers. Yeah. I mean, it's really, really fun.
And for us beaders, if you do embroidery, then, you know, you can do anything, right? Just beautiful embroidery kits. You can just take a little teeny segment of that and use that, you know, as your little piece of jewelry. But for us, we're into beads, and it's hard not to bead something, right?
It is. We have to put beads everywhere.
Yeah. But you don't have to.
That's true. And, well, I hope you really enjoyed this video. For us, it was so much fun to do this because it's new for us. And it's getting very trendy. We've seen a lot more of embroidery pendant. And really, those non-design kits are so easy to use, and that would be a good start if you don't know where to go first. Well, Sherry, thank you very much for joining me today.
Thank you.
That was such fun to do this together. And I think we're going to have another field trip to the store and get some more fabrics.
Oh, so fun.
Well, thank you so much for joining us today. And please make sure to subscribe to our email newsletter to get our promotion and some more of those great ideas. Thank you again, Sherry.
Thank you.
Merci beaucoup. Au revoir. À bientôt.
Bye-bye.